A pacemaker is an artificial pulse generator that delivers an electrical current to the heart to stimulate depolarization. Pacemaker parts. Pacemaker system consists of a pulse generator, which is the power source, and pacing leads. These are insulated wires used to carry an electrical impulse from the pacemaker to the patient's heart. It also carries information about the heart's electrical activity back to the pacemaker. Now, there are several types of pacemakers. The first one is the single channel pacemaker. Carries electrical impulses from the pulse generator to either the right atrium or right ventricle. This picture shows it coming to the right ventricle, but it can be a single channel pacemaker and stop right here in the atrium. So what's happening is this pulse generator is sending an electrical signal, and it sends that electrical signal right here at the end of the lead. Dual chamber pacemaker carries an electrical impulses from pulse generator to both the right atrium and the right ventricle of the heart. The impulses help control timing of contractions between the two chambers. So there's one in the atrium, the right atrium, and the right ventricle. The last one is a biventricular pacemaker. Carries electrical impulses from the pulse generator to the right atrium and right and left ventricles of the heart. So you see, here's one, it's going in the right atrium, it's going into the right ventricle, and this is going into the coronary sinus of the left ventricle. Now, we're going to talk about pacemaker, the functions, and how it can malfunction. The first one we're going to talk about is pacing. This is when the delivered pacemaker impulse results in depolarization of the corresponding cardiac chamber. This is a successful pacing or capture. So when we talk about the different pacemaker spikes, we're going to say this is an atrial pacer, a ventricular pacer, stuff like that. Now, the malfunction is the failure to pace. The pacemaker malfunction that occurs when the pacemaker fails to deliver an electrical impulse. When this happens, the underlying rhythm for which the pacemaker was implanted returns. So, this is an atrial pacer. So, you've got a normal sinus. This is a ventricular escape beat. Okay, so we've paced it. So there's atrial pacer, so it's a sinus, it's sinus. The next pacing should have been right here, but it didn't pace. So we've got a little arrest going on here, and then this ventricular escape beat comes back. The next one is failure to capture. So this is the inability of the pacemaker stimulus to depolarize the myocardium. Okay? The pacemaker fires, but no depolarization occurs. It's recognized on the ECG by visible pacemaker spikes, not followed by a P wave in atrial pacing or QRS complexes if it's ventricular pacing. So it paced here, 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 and here, but there's no waveform after it, so it failed to capture. The pacemaker sent the signal, but nothing happened. Sensitivity. This is the extent to which a pacemaker recognizes intrinsic electrical activity. When an intrinsic event is sensed, the pacemaker does not initiate the electrical impulse in the same chamber. The pacemaker should sense what the heart is doing on its own, so it doesn't send out an electrical stimulus at a time when the heart is more vulnerable. So failure to sense is when the pacemaker fails to recognize the spontaneous myocardial depolarization. The heart is beating just fine, but the pacemaker fires anyway. And you can recognize this because spikes are not in a consistent place before either the P wave or the QRS complex. So right here is the P wave, okay? And this is the spike. So it should have sensed the P wave and not sent a signal out, but this did. So it failed to sense it. You can also have oversensing. This results when there is inappropriate sensing of extraneous electrical signals, such as skeletal muscle activity or electrical interference. These electrical signals are interpreted by the pacemaker as intrinsic activity, and as a result, the pacemaker does not fire. So it fired here, here, it should have fired here, and it should have fired here, but it's picking up, it thinks this is, it thinks that interference is intrinsic electrical activity, so it doesn't fire, so it oversenses.